Hi, I'm Jen. Thanks for stopping by. Are you a new teacher just getting into technology in a curriculum? Or are you a veteran teacher who is getting comfortable with the idea of technology as a learning tool? I hope I can help all teachers get more acquainted with the Google Apps for Education in an early elementary setting. I have compiled a lot of information as an overview to illustrate how the Google products can be easily integrated into a preschool, pre-K, or kindergarten classroom. Each of these products can have their own videos to elaborate on the full abilities, but here I will delve briefly into a few Google apps as to not overwhelm a teacher who is just starting out with the G Suite. So use this chart as a map and take these ideas as a starting point. Where to begin? Let's start with Google Classroom. Google Classroom, as a parent resource, can be a mission control center. Handouts can be found easily, even when it's distributed in September and you need it in March. The About page acts as a file cabinet, and now Google added the label feature, so searching can be easy with keywords. Brand new to Google Classroom is the Email Guardian Summaries. Here I have shared a great tutorial on how to send batch emails to guardians. The stream can be how parents see the daily workings of the class or even a weekly newsletter. If your school does not have Google Classroom, you can still do similar concepts with the G Suite, Google Apps for Education. You can use Google Docs to publish student work, email parents, or add them as collaborators to get updates in real time. Try this language arts lessons with the Community Club read-along books. Students may vote on which community member they would like to read about, and then use Google Docs to type a letter to real community members in their area. Here we have a math lesson with numbers. Start out with an identifying numbers game on the smart board, then using Google Sheets to illustrate the amount of squares to the coinciding number. Colors are created by the fill color icon on the format bar. If you remember the Microsoft Paint program, Google Drawings is very similar. I have included a video on how to create a mind map or a visual brainstorm with drawing. This can be used as whole class instructions about a story, vocab, or even maybe classroom rules. Or let the students create masterpieces themselves as they navigate through shapes and colors to create an image. Google Slides can be a fantastic tool in the classroom. The lessons and activities are endless. Here I have an idea about creating an autobiography. I have linked to a simple template to get started. Teachers and students can work together to design and add details. The setting for the template slides are the same size of a book page, so print them out when completed and students can take their books home. Since each student learns best in different ways, the Chrome Web Store can be a resource that best fits anyone's needs. If a student has a hard time with fine motor skills, maybe a read-to-text extension would be helpful. If a student is dyslexic, the extension Open Dyslexic will format text to be easier read. There are Chrome extensions that can help just about everyone. I have included here a great article from readingrocks.org on different devices and web resources for students with learning disabilities. To conclude, we have briefly tapped into how the Google Classroom and the rest of the G Suites can be a learning tool in an early elementary classroom. Each of these apps have so many capabilities. Great thing is, if your school does not have Google Classroom, that does not mean you can't use Google in your instruction. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this helpful. Feel free to leave comments and ideas. You can find links to resources and in the description below. And while you're down there, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.